Hello everybody and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we are going to talk about how you can curb impulse shopping. Now this happens with us many times that at home we decide that I just want one product, say just one lipstick, and when we go to the cosmetic store or the makeup counter, they have such beautiful presentation. They have so many products lined up, lip liners bhi hote hain, then lipstick is there, then apart from the lipstick you'll have, you know, the kajals and then the eyeshadows and then the concealers, and the salesperson also sells all the products so beautifully. Madam, ye bhi aapko suit kar raha hai, wo bhi aapko suit kar raha hai, and then you think ki ha ha, ye acha lag raha hai, I'll buy this. And instead of buying just that one lipstick, you end up buying 10 different products. And when you come home and take a look at the amount of shopping that you have done, you finally think ki ye maine kyun kharida, I just didn't need that many things. So then sometimes you also, you know, get angry at yourself ki are maine to ek hi kharidna tha, kyun maine itna kuch liya. And very few people actually have that amount of self-control to say that no, I don't want the 100 other things that you're showing me. Mujhe sirf wo lipstick chahiye. Please bill me for that so that I can pay for it and leave. If you are able to have that amount of control, that kind of control, toh fir mera shat shat pranam hai aapko, because very few people have that. And if you have that, it's a prized thing. Please keep and preserve it as much as you can. But for a majority of us, that is not the case. So we always try to look for ways in which we can curb shopping. Now that the lockdown is being lifted, it's all the more difficult for you to curb your impulse purchasing, because we are going to have a chance to actually go to a makeup store and purchase makeup. And obviously there will be a few things that we had been looking at for the past few months online and didn't actually have a chance to purchase. So that's why today I'm going to be talking about a few pointers that I have which help me in curbing the impulse purchasing. So I hope these points are also helpful to you, and even if 10% of it is being helpful for you, then I'm sure it's going to make a difference. So let's get started. Now when we are at home, different brands advertise their products through social media influencers. So there are YouTubers and Instagrammers who use the products and give you their first-hand feedback, their reviews and their first impressions of using a particular brand or their new products that they have. Now out of this, so many products and brands that we see on social media, of course there will be a few of them that we really like. We feel, ye mere upar kaisa lagega? What if I can try? Leke dekhun kya? When you have that kind of a situation, the first thing is to note that brand down, that product down, and keep it in your mind for 2-3 days. Think about it, whether you really want it or not. And in those 2-3 days, there are a few things that I want you to do. The first thing that you can do is look for Instagrammers or YouTubers who are a similar skin tone or a similar skin type as you. So when they use a particular product, you know that what kind of an effect it has on them, and you will have a fair idea of how it will look or feel on you. Agar kisi Instagrammer or YouTuber ka skin tone or skin type aapke jaisa hai, to if they use a particular product, you will know ki agar wo main lagaungi to mere upar wo kaisa dikhega. Ek fair idea mil jata hai. So in that way, you can weed out those products and those brands which are not suitable to you. When it comes to makeup products, try to look in your vanity. You might have something which might help you create the same kind of look that you want from that new product. For example, agar market mein ek naya red eyeliner aata hai, you might think ki I really need this red eyeliner, ye to mere upar bahut acha lagega. But you can also create the same red eyeliner look with a red matte lipstick if you have one. Ya fir ek red liquid lipstick bhi agar aap use karenge, to aap red eyeliner look usse bhi create kar sakte hain. You don't need a separate red eye pencil for it. So in that way also you can eliminate a few products. Also try to study how to use a particular product. If you're going to purchase a particular eyeshadow, you might want to see the different kind of looks that can be created. What are the different possibilities of using that particular eyeshadow? Agar aap online jaake dekhenge, aapko pata chalega ki different influencers ek particular eyeshadow ko kaise use karte hain. Kitne different eye makeup looks aap create kar sakte hain. Do you really want to create those kind of eye looks for yourself or not? And then decide whether you want it or not. Now, another thing that you can do is when you're looking for one particular product, you can look at different brands which have the same product. Say if you are looking at kajal, agar aap ek kajal lene ja rahe hain aur aapko plum ka kajal aapko lag raha hai ki bahut acha hai, So what are the other brands which have kajal? So there is Faces, there is Maybelline, there is L'Oreal, there is Forever 52. So there are so many brand options that you have. Ab unme un sab ki reviews bhi aap dekh sakte hain, and you can find any other brand which is of similar quality but maybe of a lesser price. तो ऐसा भी कभी कभी होता है कि कोई ऐसा भी ब्रांड हो सकता है जिनका प्रोडक्ट बहुत अच्छा है लेकिन उनके प्राइस कम है. तो उनका एडवर्टाइजिंग कम हो सकता है लेकिन उनका प्रोडक्ट अच्छा होता है. सो इन दैट वे यू कैन चूज एन ऑल्टरनेट विच इज मे बी प्राइस्ड लेसर एंड ट्राई टू यूज इट. अगर वो आपको नहीं काम कर रहा है, सपोज यू आर यूजिंग अ लेसर priced brand and it's not working for you, maybe then you can think about switching to a higher priced brand. So in that way you can first try a lower priced brand and see if it works for you. Now even after all of this screening, you find that you still need that particular brand and that particular product, you can look at different options of purchasing. Sometimes when you go to the beauty store, it might be cheaper than online. Or even online stores, you might have one particular store offering a lesser discount and the other one offering a higher level of discount. Of course, you have to look at the aspect of whether it is expiring earlier or later. But still, there are different places at which you can purchase that particular product. Agar aapko offline lena hai, online lena hai, ek particular store se lena hai, Amazon se lena hai, Nykaa se lena hai, Purple se lena hai. Still, compare the prices between all of this and then see where you're getting the best deal and purchase it from there. Now let's talk about a situation where you have already decided the brand and the product and you have also decided yeah, I'm not going to go to the shop and I'm going to purchase it only on an online app. Or even if you purchase it at the same price, you might be purchasing it say 10% off, but you have to consider what about sale season. Almost most of the apps do announce a sale once every quarter. 3 महीने में एक बार तो सेल आती ही है. से सपोज Amazon या Nykaa ले लो या फिर Purple ले लो या फिर एनी अदर ऐप. तो यू माइट वॉन्ट टू कंसिडर कि मैं थोड़ा देर अगर रुक जाऊँगी, सपोज 2 महीने 3 महीने रुक जाऊँगी, तो शायद मुझे सेम प्रोडक्ट जो आज 10% ऑफ में मिल रहा है, आई माइट गेट इट 25-30 और इवन 50% ऑफ, समटाइम्स 70% ऑफ तक भी जाता है. सो इफ़ यू कैन वेट फॉर दैट मच ऑफ अमाउंट ऑफ टाइम, यू माइट सेव सम मोर मनी. और अगर सपोज सेल में उतना ऑफ नहीं भी हुआ तो 10% तो रहेगा ही रहेगा, तो एनीवेज यू माइट परचेज. जो आप 10% ऑफ में लेने वाले थे आपको सेम प्राइस में ही सेल में भी मिल जाए. सो यू माइट वॉन्ट टू थिंक अबाउट दैट, सोच के देखो. नाउ व्हेन यू गो टू अ ब्यूटी स्टोर एंड मेक अ परचेज, हाउ डू यू कर्ब इम्पल्स परचेजिंग देयर? Suppose you went to purchase a particular lipstick and you also ended up selecting a few lip liners and say kajal and foundation along with it. Keep it in your shopping cart and go around the whole store. Spend time looking at other products, other brands and maybe other items which you may or may not need. This will give you time to rethink the items that are already there in your cart. By the time you reach the teller or the salesperson or the cashier, you will be able to know what are the products that you need. You can rethink it at that stage and remove the items that you don't need. And those are the pointers that I had to share with you today. These are the things that have helped me curb my impulse purchasing. I hope you found this video useful, and if you did, don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Also, let me know in the comment box if you have any pointers of your own which you would like to share with me. Thank you for watching this video. I will see you in my next video. Until then, I love you guys so much. Take care and stay safe. Bye-bye.